rolling on the Gold's Pity, right? If you had the option to, would you move back to Gloucester Chambers with everything the way it used to be?
No.
Why not?
We were too far out. I mean, at the time, it was the only room available because the whole place was occupied. It was a thriving community of small businesses. I was lucky to get the one room that was available. But it was a good starting point for this premises, both because it's lower in the building, it's on the first floor. It's much better location from that point of view, sort of thing, you know. But it certainly stood us in good stead when we first moved in there.
For
accessibility for customers, this is a better, only one flight of stairs.
That's good. How do you feel about Gloucester Chambers currently being a dysfunctional and derelict space?
Well, it's criminal what's happened to the place, because as I said, it was a thriving community, and possibly there would have been businesses there, even like Len Coles who's spoken. I may well have still been there myself anyway. We were basically forced out. Because over the years, the landlords at the time refused to invest in the building and the roof. I mean, there were three floors above me, and yet we were getting water in. They were seeping in from the roof. So how far was that water travelling? So when you're trying to keep your business, you know, nice environment, and you're spending a lot of money, and you've got water coming through your ceiling and destroying everything you're trying to work for, you just can't carry on like that. And that's why everybody moved, because the place was falling down around us, the toilets were becoming unusable, the lifts stopped working, everything froze up in the winter. I mean, it was just virtually impossible to run your business there. You know, we were basically forced out. But as I said, if the investment had been put in there, that thriving community would have probably carried on, because as I said, all the rooms were occupied.
All
the rooms were occupied. It was terrific, you know.
You just unfortunately moved out because of the safety side of things, rather than them trying to make use of the space. They just forced you out because it's unsafe.
They just refused to amend the problems, and we just couldn't carry on working in that environment, you know.
What businesses do you remember most that were within Gloucester Chambers?
Well, next door to me was Rowe Finance, Mr. Thomas, and the fashion shop that was on the corner. What was the name of the fashion shop that was on the corner?
Up where?
At the top here, I can't remember.
Grizzell, is it?
No, not Grizzell. Anyway, there's a fashion shop up on the corner. They had a storeroom next door to us, which they frequented, obviously. Mr. Thomas was finance. Went down the corridor then. There was Highway School of Motor in. Clobber, the gentleman's outfit that's from across the road, boutique. They had an office there and stock room. Len Coles, obviously. There was Val Williams, who was the alteration tailors. Upstairs was the printers, can't remember George the printer was up there, he was an Irish chap. Stills Design Group, I think, were in there at one time. Can't remember all the businesses from up there. There was a lot of businesses in the area that had shops. Not at that time, not to my recollection. There was a lot of businesses that had worked in the area, but they had offices and things which they could use for popping in and out, that sort of thing, you know. There was also a caretaker that lived on the premises, Mrs. Hennessy. Yeah, so she lived there all the time. She was absolutely fantastic, a good character, you know what I mean? Looked after the building, kept it going as much as she could until basically she was forced out, but she lived there with the daughter, and I think the son was there at one time, right?
It was interesting how there was a lady caretaker back then, because before then, the quality just started. So more than likely, back then, the majority of caretakers would have been men.
Yeah.
And it's interesting that it's a lady.
Yeah, Mrs. Hennessy.
Yeah. What's your strongest memory of Gloucester Chambers?
Different things at different times. Obviously, moving in for the first time, getting the shop involved. I mean, I was... I got a change of career slightly from ladies' hairdressing. I went repping and then came back into gents' hairdressing. So I had this idea of a barbershop in Newport, because it was the 70s and mainly most of the boys weren't having a haircut anyway. They all had long hair. So when they wanted a cut, they had to go to somebody who wanted to whack it all off, sort of thing.
Okay.
My hair was as long as theirs.
Yeah.
So it was the start of the business. The friends that we made through the association, Len and Clobber and all that sort of stuff. Mrs. Hennessy was a character. She, we always went to see her at Christmas, and I helped her out at times when she was...
Was she still about?
I don't think so, no. She was more than drunk. She had a good thing of whiskey. Another time when it was frozen up, everything was frozen there, and I went to see her, and she was in dire straits because she had no water on tap there. She was filling her saucepans up with snow and melting the snow to just have her, make herself a cup of tea. And that was the bad side of it, you know, watching the place decay around us. So yeah, good and bad memories from it. You know.
Thank you very much.
Right, sunshine, your magic, lovely.